So a very good evening to you all. I'm Tinashe Gwarazimba and welcome to Zim Updates, stories making the headlines. So China says Western sanctions on Zimbabwe must be removed. So the unilateral sanctions imposed by some countries and organizations on Zimbabwe have no basis in international law and they violate the legitimate development rights and interests of Zimbabwe, said Wang Yi, China's foreign minister. So Vice President Bohadi loses 271 cattle to drought. Other farmers lose their entire herds. So the drought ravaging parts of Zimbabwe is taking its toll in Matabeleland South, where Vice President Kebo Mahadi has so far lost 271 cattle, with the figures continuing to increase as he is now losing an average of 10 beasts per day. So China praises VP Chiwenga for contributing to China-Zimbabwe relations. So the visiting China Foreign Minister Wang Yi yesterday praised acting President Constantino Chiwenga for contributing towards the development of solid China-Zimbabwe relations and said China believes that Zimbabwe has the wisdom and the ability to overcome the temporary difficulties. So Qatar Airways expresses interest in flying the Zimbabwean route. So the leading global airliner Qatar Airways has expressed interest in flying the Zimbabwean route and last week dispatched a senior official to Zimbabwe to explore the possibilities of adding Harare to its 150 destinations across the world. And Combi's treble fares as Zupco buses pull out citing poor roads. So bus operators under the Zimbabwe United Passenger Company Public Transport Facility have withdrawn their buses from servicing the suburb of Cowdery Park in Lawayo, citing bad roads leading to commuter omnibuses raising the fares. So, a son axes father to death. Mother tries to conceal murder. So, a 19-year-old man from Inyati in Bubi District, Matabeleland North Province, allegedly fatally struck his father with an axe and his mother attempted to conceal the murder by lying that her husband fell onto a wreck. So an arrested army accountant's wife splashes off riches on social media. So following the arrest of the Ministry of Defense and War Veterans Affairs accountant Simbarashe Jinei for allegedly misappropriating over 20 million in army funds and channeling them for personal use, several photographs of the accused's wife slaying it on social media and showing off top of the range vehicles have emerged. So Madam Boss earns much more than PhD holders, Dr. Mambondiani. So Benge ABC Managing Director Dr. Mambondiani has revealed that in this day and age, as well as going forward, knowledge does not exactly equate to high earnings, but what is important is what one does with their knowledge. So Dr. Mambondiani, a former chief executive officer at Stewart Bank, advises youth and adults alike to stop thinking in terms of the current educational setup, which was built for the colonial past, not for the present. So Caledonia gets record gold production from Blanket Mine. So London Stock Exchange listed Caledonia Mining Corporation has produced a record gold output in 2019. And Chief Executive Steve Curtis said that the improvement in the electricity supply and rigid focus on grade control had helped boost production at the Blanket Gold Mine in Zimbabwe by 24% over the previous quarter and by 13% compared to the corresponding quarter in 2018. So ZESA approaches Afrexim over Eskom debt. So state-owned power utility ZESA says it is in talks with the African Export-Import Bank to help clear $70 million of arrears it owes to power producers in neighboring South Africa and Mozambique. So Wajigajena agrees with BT that Mashurugu have support from politicians. So ZANU-PF legislator for Gokwe Nembudzia constituency in the Midlands province, Justice Mayor Wajigajena says he agrees with recent utterances by MDC Vice President Tendai Biti that machete-wielding gangs are being supported and sponsored by politicians to wreak havoc across the country. So, court cases to be streamed live to improve transparency, Malava. So, selected court cases of national and public interest will be streamed live. The most watched court case that was streamed live in recent time was the August 2018 election petition by MDC leader Nelson Chamisa against the Zimbabwe Electoral Commission and ZANU-PF, which was unanimously thrown out by all the 9 constitutional judges for lack of evidence. So that's all we had for you today. We hope to see you tomorrow for another episode and another edition of Zim Updates with Nashibara Zim.